Hello everyone, I'm Dr. Amr ElKhadem. I'm a professor of prosthodontics in Cairo University. I'm also the director of the Cairo Implant Academy. One might ask, what is different with the full arch scans? The problem with the full arch scans, especially when you're doing screw retained restoration, is that very minor errors will contribute to passivity problems. What do I mean by passivity problems? It means that the screws for the full arch will not go easily into place. And this is what we do with what we call a single screw test and a screw resistance test. The idea about using the photogrammetry is to produce a very accurate scan with a very low margin of error, probably below 30, maybe below 10 or 5 microns. As we go very low with the accuracy errors, we get a more passive restorations. And we can check this with our patient that we got our scan with the photogrammetry technique from Shining, and we can see how passive the case goes. This is a scan made by the photogrammetry of the Elite, and it's really 100% passive from the first try. The problem with the photogrammetry devices available in the market that they are very expensive. And this is why the photogrammetry devices are not very familiar, especially in dentists not doing a lot of full arch cases. You see, this is the new scanner from Shining. This scanner is relatively one of the smallest scanners I have ever used in my practice. The scanner is actually smaller than the palm fist, and it's coming with different scanner tips. You can see we have different sizes for the scanner tips to suit different positions. I believe because of this very nice tip, this big window, and the engine inside here, the scanning speed is really very fast, especially when doing the edentulous cases. Probably you can see now working on the background, a scan for the mandibular patient, and you can see how fast the tracking of the scan using the scanner, it's really very fast and really very efficient. And probably you will be seeing a lot of nice results of accuracy. When I go to the photogrammetry option, it starts scanning the special scan bodies called the smart, the scan pegs or the scan picks. Those scan picks, when scanned, they are scanned with the photogrammetry and not the structured light technique. And this helps us to get a very accurate scan for the implants in the full arch cases without using the conventional structured light. Because it's not only a structured light scanner, like the ordinary scanners, it's also handling us like a photogrammetry option. Example of what the scanner is capable to do. This is for the demonstration. I have a scan for an edentulous patient, both maxillary and the mandibular. If you look here with the mandibular arches, it's a little bit more difficult to scan the case accurately. And this is where the photogrammetry comes in place. The photogrammetry tools we use, after being fastened to the patient and we take the scan, they are automatically replaced with those scan bodies for the specific system we choose. And this is how your file is transferred to the lab. You just have a scan which is much more accurate than your conventional scan body scan. And finally, the lab receives this scan with the lab scan bodies. When you have this scanner, the face scanner, the Elite scanner and the software and probably the DICOM of the patient, you can integrate all this data in what we call the virtual patient, which is actually the dream of every prosthodontist. I believe what the guys in Shining 3 have done with this Elite scanner can be a game changer in the full arch cases, because it's not only a regular scanner, it's a very small, fast scanner, but also it is a photogrammetry device, which is the gold standard for the full arch cases. So by integrating those two nice technologies in one small scanner, I believe this is going to change the strategy for scanners in the coming years.